We're going to say before we learn the different types of chemical bonds, we have to first ask ourselves, why do elements want to form bonds in the first place? Well, we know that the two major types of bondings that exist, we've talked about. We have covalent compounds and ionic compounds. Covalent compounds have covalent bonds. Ionic compounds have ionic bonds. Now, we're going to say that generally, the reason that ionic bonding forms is because it lowers the potential energy between positive and negative ions. Remember, when two things are forming a bond, they're releasing energy. Them releasing energy makes them move slower. Because they're moving slower, they're able to combine more together. And remember, if we're forming a bond, it's an exothermic reaction, or an exergonic reaction if we're talking about energy. If you're losing energy, you're going to become more stable. In chemistry, you're more stable when you have less energy. It's all about minimizing the amount of energy you possess. And ionic bonding does that. Now, we're going to say generally, the reason that covalent bonds form is to follow what we call the octet rule. We'll learn more about the octet rule later, but just realize for now, the octet rule just means elements are then surrounded by 8 valence electrons. We'll learn that some elements usually follow the octet rule, but there are others that break them. Some may have less than 8 valence electrons, some may have more than 8 valence electrons. When we come to those topics, we'll see them more in depth.